Deadline. Breaking: Nnamdi Kanu arrives court premises amidst tight security. Detained leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Mr. Nnamdi Kanu has arrived at the Abuja division of the Federal High Court venue of his trial over allegations of terrorism and treasonable felony. Although his visuals could not be gotten, he was, however, believed to be among a convoy of about 6 vehicles that drove into the court premises around 8 a.m. on Thursday morning by operatives of the Department of State Security Service, DSS. The convoy was led by a black Prado Jeep, followed by 2 Hilux, 2 buses, and 2 other Hilux. Before his arrival, security operatives, including DSS, Nigerian Army, police, and the NSCDC, had cordoned off all entrances leading to the headquarters of the Federal High Court, Abuja. Even staff of the Federal High Court had to alight from their staff bus to be screened before they were allowed to go in. Nnamdi Kanu was arraigned alongside 4 others on 6-count criminal trial charge bordering on alleged terrorism and treasonable felony in 2016. He pleaded not guilty to the charges and was admitted to bail in the sum of 100 million, with 3 sureties in the sum like of the of which the serving senator Hinaya Abaribe was one of the sureties. It was said that he jumped bail in 2017 after his family house in Afarauku, Abia State, was invaded by personnel of the Nigerian Army and killed some people, and even his parents lost their life in the process. And following jumping of the bail, Justice Binta Nyako had voided the bill and issued a warrant for his arrest. Only a few days ago, the federal government had amended the charge to 7, and it will be recalled that the court had in 2019 separated Kanu's trial from the others after a jumped bill and ordered his trial in absentia. Also, the United Kingdom was said to have given him consular support.
As well in this case, because as at now, what should actually preoccupy many of them at is for the president himself, President Muhammadu Buhari, to have a renewed mindset and release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu from the detention, because it has been a while now that people have asked for seeing him, and this would actually continue to cause mayhem in the nation. And when he's released, it is most likely that, in fact, that would put a stop to the sit at home order that has been going on in some parts of the southeast. Words of Ike Ekweremadu. He also says that in the absence of violent agitation, how can we address the issue of exclusion, imbalances, the detention of so many Igbo sons and daughters in various correctional facilities across the country, the issues of the clampdown on unarmed protesters and challenge of extrajudicial killings in Igboland in the most effective manner. Let me also assure you that the Southeast Caucus of the National Assembly is not resting on its laurels, Ekweremadu said of Kanu. We are working quietly and steadily to address these issues, which includes finding a political solution to the Mazi Nnamdi Kanu situation. We appreciate your understanding. Previously, in the case of Chief Raf, who was Ruike in 2007, we had done something similar. In the case of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, we did the same thing last year, and God willing, and with the help, with your help and prayers, we will be successful in our efforts to bring Nnamdi Kanu to justice once more to promote peace and stability in the southeastern region. Ekweremadu, on the other hand, urged Igbos living in diaspora to express an interest in the leadership positions in Igbo territory. In Ala Igbo, the Igbo diaspora must demonstrate more than a passing interest in the recruitment of leaders at all levels of organization. Please, if at all possible, return to your hometown and run for public office. Those who are unable to return home should encourage and support alternative candidates of their choosing. It is critical to ensure that our elected officials at all levels of government, including local, state, and federal, are best, and those who have best interest at heart. That, in my opinion, marks the beginning of the real emancipation struggle for Indigo, because charity, they see, starts at home. And these were the words of Ike Ekweremadu concerning the ongoing mayhem in the southeastern part of the country, and also the detention of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who is presently at the DSS facility of which it was said that the federal government is fully aware of the October 24, 2021, which was actually a day that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu will be tried again at the Court of Law in Abuja. The lawmaker, that is his legal defense, the lead AGO4, actually says that as a result of the fact that the federal government knows that October 24, 2021 is the date, that nothing will actually stop them from presiding on that day, because it has been rumored that they are attempting not to bring Nnamdi Kanu to court that very day, seeing that as a result, they have no logical excuse not to bring Uyedumazi Nnamdi Kanu to court on that Thursday, October 24, 2021, seeing that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu himself has actually begged millions of his friends and followers to continue to conduct themselves and operate within the ambit of law as they have always done, seeing that more noticeable and commendable is the fact that their solidarity has stayed unbroken even in the face of all adversity, for which he is truly grateful. And therefore, Ikurimadu himself, which is actually a former deputy president of the Senate, actually called the Alaigbori himself that they need, especially those ones living in diaspora, that is outside the country, that they need to start speaking against violent agitations, saying that the lawmaker actually opened up this virtual lecture, you know, in South Africa, where he actually talked about this the Igbo in diaspora, a perspective which he delivered at the Igbo Heritage Lecture. During this lecture, he actually observed that a whole lot of worse things that could happen to Indigo at this time would be to their homeland to be turned into a battleground for another time in history, saying that it is imperative that the injustices and the marginalization that exist should be addressed, and in any case, they must ensure that there is stability of Igboland, because only in this way will the Igboland, which they call Alaigbo, be prosperous economically while also eliciting local and international sympathy and support for their predicament. In the past few months, they see that there has been a whole lot of mayhem in the southeastern region, and it was sacrosanct for the Igbos in diaspora and every other Alaigbo to support themselves towards exposure to liberal and progressive democratic ideals, as well as access to international resources, seeing that the many Igbo sons and daughters have actually been detained in various correctional facilities across the country, and the issues of the clampdown on unarmed protesters and the challenge of extrajudicial killings in Igboland in the most effective manner was needed, seeing that he assures them that the Southeast Caucus of the National Assembly is not resting on Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's case, because they are finding a political solutions to his situation, and they appreciate their understanding. Thanks for listening. That's it.